Welcome to our 34th anniversary celebration. We're so glad that you're here. Amen. Yeah. Thank you all for coming and joining in this celebration with us. We are delighted to see so many of our friends and people that hadn't been in a while back with us today. Just warms the heart and makes me just smile. I really am glad you're all here, and I'm really glad God's here too. And he's going to do some great things in this place today. I'm looking forward to what he's going to do. So welcome. We're glad you're here. Praise Center, let all of our guests know how glad you are that they're here. Amen. Amen. All right, why don't you stand just for a minute and greet three or four people and just let them know you're glad to see them. Y'all just start.
Yeah. head, water falling like a song. Yeah. An everlasting stream, your river carries me home. Let it flow, let it flow. Never will run dry.
breast cancer, stage 4, that had spread to the liver and the bones. We've been doing chemo, and y'all have been praying, and other churches have been praying for me. Well, we had a CAT scan done 2 weeks ago, Monday. Last week, we got the results, and the cancer has gone out of the lymph nodes. It's 50 to 70% gone out of the liver, and over 50% gone out of the bone. So, thank y'all.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Presence, God is here, pushing back the darkness. Amen. Glory to God. What a great day to be in the house of the Lord, to be with His children, to be with His people, and to know that He is inhabiting the praises of His people, and His inhabiting power is here to change lives. And we've already seen one life that's just been changed last Sunday. Amen. Congratulations, Robbie. We're proud of you. Proud of what the Lord is doing. He's answering prayers every time. It is His will that none perish, that all should come to repentance and be saved and call upon the name of all names, Jesus Christ. And that's what He did a week ago. And God bless Him for following through with that. It's great to see you here. We're going to be highlighting a lot of the different ministries that the Praise Center has going on. And the first one we're going to do is the care ministry. So if the care ministry representatives will come and take care of that. All right, welcome Miss Nancy, please. Hallelujah. And while she's coming, if the life groups testimonies will get ready there, you're coming next, okay? We need a microphone.
But the first thing I want to do is to get you to think what it would be like if we didn't if we didn't have care ministry, and you all didn't have the heart of care ministers, which you do. I'm not saying you don't, okay? So imagine you live nearby here, and you don't know the Lord, and but you know there's something really missing in your life, and it's been missing for a long time, and you drive by TPC every day, and then you feel yourself drawn to come in here. And we have people tell us a lot of times that this is what happens. They just feel drawn to be here. And so imagine that you know, one Sunday you get up and you're going to the drive-thru for breakfast, and you have on your sweatsuit and your fuzzy bunny slippers. And you just are driving down the road, and then you say, you just find yourself driving into the parking lot, and you walk up, and you have to open the door yourself, and you walk in, and there are people standing around, and they're laughing and talking and sharing with each other, but they don't even turn their heads, and you have to open the door yourself and come in, and you walk past them, and they don't look at you unless they look at your fuzzy bunny slippers in a strange way. And you just find your way to the sanctuary because you hear music, and you sit down, and no one greets you or sits by you, and the music is great, and the pastor gives this stirring sermon, and you feel something, but then it's over, and everybody gets up and hugs each other, and they walk out, and then you find your way back to your car, and your life is not changed, and whatever was planted, the seed that was planted and it had sprouted, it's just withered and it's died, and an opportunity has passed. And so this is what Care Ministry is here for, to make sure none of that happens. And so I want to ask the care ministers just come and stand up front so you know who we are. And even if you signed up and you haven't gotten to serve yet this month, just come on up. So thanks to these folks and the care ministry and the vision that the pastor has given us for the care ministry, what this scenario that I described is not happening here, and our availability gives God an opportunity to work a miracle through us. And we have the opportunity to show the love of Jesus to those. We have the first opportunity to show the love of Jesus to people who come onto the church property. And there are lots of things that we get to enjoy. We get to hug people and greet them and give them cookies and gifts and show them where the facilities are and walk them to the sanctuary and introduce them to the pastor. And most people who join the care ministry, they stay. They don't ever leave us. So I have this feeling that everyone enjoys what they do. And anytime you want to find out about that, you can let me know. And the truth is that we're all care ministers, and I just like to say that it's a blessing to see how all of you are acting as care ministers. And I see many people, when you see someone you don't know, you walk up and introduce yourselves. And so I just like to thank you for that, and and ask you to just keep doing that, and invite you to all, stay as care ministers. And if you see someone you don't know, be sure and tell them about the other ministries at the church: the women's ministry, the men's ministry, youth, children's, life groups, Wednesday night dinners, intercessory prayer, servant evangelism, nursery, and just make yourselves available like you have been. And I'd like to thank everyone.
Good morning, TPC. How's everyone doing this morning? Speak up. All right, that's what I want to hear. Now, from what Nancy just said, we're going to continue with that ministry in life groups. That's what I like to hear. I have a couple of friends of mine. They want to say a few words, not at the same time, but one at a time. Barry Rudd.
Love you, brother. You know, my wife and I started coming here about 2.5 years ago, and we were pretty beat up, pretty hurt, and best way to put it is probably shipwrecked. We started coming here, came, and I would sit in the back row and enjoy the service and sneak out, and this went on, and the Lord kept tugging at my heart. And about 1.5 years later, we joined the church. And this is, this goes in line with what the pastor's vision is of this church and the hospital, and we were pretty wounded when we got here. And just the love of the church and what they've done in our life has restored, this church restoration has restored our hope, our vision in the Lord, and has just really been a phenomenal work in my life as far as my walk with the Lord. Just an example and a fruit of that, Bonnie's in Africa ministering right now. But the thing I'm up here to talk about is Fred and the life group. I'm sorry, but about 6 or 8 months ago, the Lord kept tugging my heart to get involved. And it's okay, you know, just at my timing. So we started going to, I call it the blue hair group. Some of us have blue hair. Some of us have blue hair, some of us have brown hair, and some of us have no hair. Where's Rick? But that's the thing about this group is we laugh till we cry, and they've loved on us, and it's been a place where these people are real. And that's the amazing thing about it. When I started going on Monday nights with these guys, there was no push. It was just we got to enjoy each other's fellowship and love on each other and accept us for who we are and where we're at. And I just want to say thank you, and it has been just an awesome encouragement to me and my family.
Next is Joe Johnson.
And if elected, I will. Promise to make promises. I would just like to say a couple of things. The small groups, I guess, is broken down into what I call two categories, one formal, the other informal. The group we go to is with Dennis and Kathleen Hood on Monday night, the same one he just elaborated on. My wife has been on my case for the last 50 years. And we have been married 50 years get involved. I couldn't join the choir because I can't sing. Well, the group on Monday night does have an exercise that I can do, and that's eat. And I'm real good at it. Ooh, excuse me. The message I would like to leave with you is there is nothing wrong with having fun. And fun is love. And our Monday night group, all of you out there, I want to thank you for taking me in. It's an excellent opportunity to meet people, to have fellowship, and to get involved in your church. And that's all I have to say about that.
You see how you're missing out? You're not in a life group. You're missing out. And if you don't like the life groups that you see on the board out there, start your own. You can take a bunch of people bowling. You can take a bunch of people on a motorcycle. Well, not yours, but theirs. Come on now. But life groups are about people. They're about you getting to know your neighbor, okay? And it's about love. We all about love. Rick Baker has a great one on Sunday night in his home. It's all about love. Eric Nielsen has one on Sunday morning, 9 o'clock. I know that's early for some of you, but most of us can make it. But join a life group or start a life group. If you need some help starting a life group, come and see me. Come and see me. I'll help you with that. It's easy. It's a lot easier. And all you have to do primarily is facilitate. You don't have to preach. You don't have to preach the word out of the Bible. It's not required. But you do have to facilitate. Make sure your group is always there and on time and together and praying. I love you all. Get involved.
Our women's ministry. Welcome, Miss Peggy. And while she's coming, if someone would cue the children, let them know they're up next, okay?
All right. I'm excited this morning, and the reason I'm double excited. First of all, my grandson's the one that got baptized. Hallelujah! And I'm excited about ladies' ministry. And I'm going to just tell you a little bit about it. The vision for the ladies' ministry for 2013, I used four words that begin with the letter P. Purpose, prayer, praise, and power. And everything that we've done, we tried to do to accomplish these things. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about what's been going on. The first thing we did at the first of the year is we took a personality test. It was a fun one. The ladies know you're either an otter, a lion, or a beaver, or a golden retriever. And if you wasn't there and you want to know all about that, just see me and I'll give you the test. That was fun, but we really got to understand more about ourselves and really more about each other. And then we've had two prayer breakfasts. We had one in the spring and another this fall that we just had, because we believe in the importance of prayer. In June, we had a luncheon, and the focus there was on faith. We called it Seeds of Faith. In July, we had a potluck dinner and a testimony night. And that was a time of sharing our heart, sharing with each other, knowing that what we shared was going to be there. If it was intimate and needed not to be shared anywhere else, there was trust and there was love given. And that was just a wonderful night. And we're going to have another one October 7th. And then all you ladies that haven't been a part of ladies' ministry, I'd love for you to come that night. You just bring a cover dish and you can just be blessed, I assure you. In August, we had a game night, and we had fun. You know, I believe it was Barry. I believe it was Barry that was talking about having fun, and I think the Lord wants us to have fun. And, you know, it's in the Bible, it says that the joy of the Lord is our strength. And I believe that, and I believe that we need to study the Word and pray and do all those things, but we need to build relationships too. And just coming together, laughing, and having a fun time builds those and strengthens those relationships. Some of the things that are coming up, we're going to have our annual Christmas banquet, which is a big thing. And we also are going to be sponsoring again the foster children, getting up gifts for the foster children. And there are a lot of other things that we do, showers, receptions, if somebody's sick, take them some food. And then we support our Impact Girls ministry. We're there to sponsor and help them. That's just a few of the things. And I'm going to leave you with this. In January, when I spoke to the ladies, there was a scripture that I'm going to share this scripture with you, because this is what I feel represents the heart of our Women of Praise ministry, and that's our name because we named ourselves this year. But it comes from Colossians 3:12-14. It says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people," and I want to say God's chosen women, "holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you, and overcome all these virtues, and over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all in perfect unity." And I feel that is what ladies is all about, being in unity and love and coming together and serving the Lord. And I want to invite all you ladies to come and be a part, because I know you will be blessed. And you will bless us being there. Thank you.
Thank you, Peggy. Thank you, Peggy. Will you please welcome our children's ministry at this time?
All right.
Testament, and we've learned about Jesus and all the miracles and the things that he did. But now we're starting on the Old Testament. We decided we needed to go back to the roots and see where we came from. And so we, I hope you saw that these kids love worship and praise. And they love to do the motions to songs. And so I just want to thank Taylor and Emma for what they have done with this song, because it's been awesome. But we have a scripture in one of our lessons. We had a psalm, and we took Psalms 100, and we divided it into four groups, and this is what they came up with.
fun to ask that if you're parents of any of these children, please stand so they can see you, because we're going to get to stay down here and be here for the rest of the anniversary service. So if you have children, please stand so they can come and sit with you.
Let's hear it for Deborah and Susan and John as they lead that children's church every time. Amen. It is time to receive the tithes and offerings. Yeah. This is why we give, is so that we can continue to have ministries to our children, our youth, our women, our men, our church celebrations. Okay? To see people baptized. That's why we give. Amen? Besides that, the Lord tells us to. And he promises to bless us tremendously when we obey him. Let's make our covenant statement together. I am a worshiper. I was created by God to worship. Therefore, as an act of worship, I bring my tithes and offerings into your storehouse. Based upon your word, I know I will be blessed, although that is not the reason I give. I give with a grateful heart because I love you and I want to honor you by obeying your word as an expression of my faith. I trust you to open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be enough room for it. I trust you to rebuke the devourer for my sake and to protect my finances. I trust you to honor your word and save my whole family that they may serve in health and abundance. And as you bless me, I will bless others and give freely as you direct me. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord.
All right. Well, great morning, Praise Center. You guys look awesome today, and it's my joy to bring to you your announcements and tell you what all is happening besides all the ministries that we have going on here. Amen? How many know this church is actively serving this community? I mean, that is what we do, right? How many remember servant evangelism? It is not what we do. It's who we are. And it really incorporates all the ministries, because Jesus came not to be served, but to serve. Amen? All right, so our next Servant Evangelism Project, y'all need to write this down, because this is a big one. On October the 19th, I don't see, there we go, some people are writing. October the 19th at 7 o'clock right here at the Praise Center, we're going to host movie night free, and it's not for us, it's for the community. Although many of us will come and watch, it will be great, but a lot of us are going to be serving. We're going to turn this place into a true theater experience. From starting at the road all the way in here, we're going to turn this place into a theater. We're going to serve. And the movie is fantastic. The movie is called Home Run. There's information out on the internet about that now. Do your research. It is a phenomenal movie about overcoming obstacles and growing a relationship with the living God. It is not about religion. It is about a relationship, and it's fantastic, and it will reach a lot of people, but that means that we have to go to work. We have to go to work. We have to get them here. So I don't care if you have to babysit for people, if you have to help arrange childcare. I think we're going to arrange a nursery here and provide it for them free. All they got to do is show up and be blessed. The movie is awesome. It's not corny at all. It's not cheesy. It is fantastic. We previewed it, and I'm telling you, I cried. Y'all are supposed to go, man, that must be a really good movie. All right, tough crowd this morning. October 19th, there's going to be a lot more information coming out about that. Mark your calendars. Make your plans now. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be a fantastic night. We're going to have previews. We're going to have commercials for up-and-coming things besides just movie night. It's going to be fun. We're going to have a good time, and we're going to wow people with the love of God. Amen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and men of TPC, ball is in the air once again, and it is time for cool temperatures, football, and you guessed it, the annual TPC barbecue. Oh, yeah! I said barbecue! Y'all are ridiculous. They don't get excited about nothing. I love to eat barbecue, and so will you if you buy your plate, because it is going to be good. I'm telling you, this year's barbecue will be held on Saturday, October the 12th, and we're expecting a huge turnout. I said a huge turnout. Ladies, 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 we will need your help that morning with fixing plates, desserts, slaw, etc., like normal. If you have missed this event in the past, believe us, you will want to purchase a plate. We're not talking chicken here. We're not talking hot dogs and hamburgers. We're talking pulled, tender Boston butt pork. We're going to smoke it all night long, 12 hours plus. And it's going to be brought to you by your very own TPC Warriors. Now, the hospitality desk has tickets already for your purchasing pleasure. Pick them up. As always, you can pick them up now and pay for them later. However, all money must be in by Sunday, October the 6th. Tickets are only $7, and you get a man's helping of a meal. Let me just tell you, it is all you can eat. Amen. All right, so Phil West, are you in here? Everybody look, there's Phil. That's who to see for more information about the barbecue. Men folk, we're going to have an awesome night that Friday night. There'll be more information about that coming. So just prepare your palates for some good barbecue. All right. Our women of praise will be hosting a ladies' potluck dinner and testimony night Monday, October the 7th at 7 p.m. This is sure to be a great night of fellowship and praise to God for what he is doing in the lives of the women here at the Praise Center and their families. Amen. All right. Our next Crossroad Workday will be Saturday, October the 5th at 9 a.m. Guys, this is a big one. We need to show up and make this one count so that we can move from the demolition and cleanup stage to the new construction phase. Amen? It's time we finish up that phase and move forward. And so we need all hands on deck Saturday, October the 5th. It's going to be a big day. Speaking of that, all you men folk, if you want to get encouraged and energized and refreshed and ready to work, be here at 7 a.m. before the workday. You're going to be fed and listen to great word given by one of our very own warriors that morning. Don't miss out. That's going to be a good time. And all the warriors said, amen. All right, October 5th, it's the District Impact Girls Celebration in Macon. Just a reminder to those of you that have daughters attending. If you have any questions, please contact Deborah Davis as soon as possible. That's it.
Praise the Lord. We are highlighting the different ministries so that you get a chance to see what all is going on here at the Praise Center. One of the things that just happened last week is we had our Life Discovery class, and I want to welcome our new members who are Covenant members. Risa Lambert, would you please come? And Daniel Howard. Daniel Howard, you just stay right here. James and Glenda Moon. Yeah. Tom Burns. He's coming. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Tom. Stay right there, please. And Donita Starks. Would you please welcome these new members to the Praise Center? Amen. Amen. Glad y'all are here. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Honeymoon's over, now it's time to go to work. Also, we have two baptism certificates, one for Mackenzie Johnson that didn't receive hers before. If you're here now, Mackenzie, where's Mackenzie? All right. Praise the Lord. Hang on 1 second. She was baptized on the 29th day of April, and she never got that, so we wanted to give that to you. God bless you. Thank you. And Robbie Elsmore, who just got baptized today. Congratulations, Robbie. Thanks, sir. Praise the Lord. All right. Praise God. I believe it's the men's turn.
Is this the broke one? Okay. As Brett said, we got barbecue coming up October 12th. Please, please, please get tickets. If you can't afford them today, just grab a stack. Just don't get too many. We printed 500. Last year we did 300. Me and Phil believing if we can hit 500, that would be awesome. Y'all got to give them out to your neighbors, to your friends, to your coworkers. You know, your non-believer friends, just give them a ticket. If you can buy it for them, there's $7. And if you sell 10, you get yours free. So that's a deal. So we got that October 12th. And men, the breakfast is October 5th. Please, please come. It's at 7 o'clock. And we're going to continue out there. If y'all hadn't seen what we've been doing, it's been a lot. We took down all the crossroad just about, and we're going to do some burning and all sorts of stuff. So please come get plugged in with us. If you haven't ever attended one, just come on, because we love each other, and we get out there with hammers and we just destroy stuff and we have a good old time. And we eat. We eat a lot, as you can tell. So, and I love this man right here. This is Phil, our head. So.
And I'm pretty good at tearing up stuff. I can do that. You know, Brother Travis and I, we work together, and we lead one of the best men's groups I've personally led and ever worked with. And I want to tell you something. Here at TPC, our men, we're involved. Yes, we're not just involved, but we're empowered. Amen. Not just empowered, but we are engaged. Yes. We want to ensure that the men's fellowship provides an opportunity where men of all ages can connect in such a way that it glorifies God, serving not only our church, but our community. God, that's right. We're here to serve. And we want to cordially invite all the men to be a part of one of the best groups out here. One of the best groups out here. Discover what and how God can use you in our group. Amen.
And teenagers, Youth guys, if you need a ride to the men's breakfast and to the work day, just see me or Phil, and I'll get you there, all right? So I know a lot of you youth can't drive, but let me know.
All right. Get a mic. Leave it on. Our nursery, our unsung heroes of the church, our nursery coordinators, Dennis and Kathleen Hood, would you welcome them? Amen. The children's ministry and the nursery make it possible for you guys to be in here and worship God in spirit and in truth. And there's not enough praise to go toward these folks here. Amen.
I'm Kathleen Hood, and Dennis and I coordinate the nursery and have people come in and serve your babies. This is one of our recent babies, and we have very few right now, but we've got more coming. These are my past babies. I'm sorry. It's just watching these guys grow up. It's like Wayne Watson sings a song, Watercolor Ponies. The way I feel with my own children, like, you know, you love it when they're there and they make those watercolor ponies and you see them growing up, but then they go on. And all my babies are grown, and my grandbabies are about grown. These are my babies too, and they're growing up. Makes me sad, but it makes me happy because they grow up to be the men and women of God. And these are not all of them, but these are just the ones that I could grab. But I just encourage any of y'all that would like to serve in the nursery and love on these babies, and these are where they start. We start with them this age, then they go on to Deborah and the other ladies and John, and then they go to the youth, and then they're you guys. And I encourage any of y'all, if you want to help serve, to see me or see Dennis and come join us, because we have a lot of fun. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Our next ministry we're highlighting today is our servant evangelism under the leadership of Brett and Lynn Davis. They're missing in action right now. Don't know where they are, so they're probably out serving or something.
Servant evangelism. That looks like fun, doesn't it? That's just a small taste of kind of what we do. We want to give things to people and let them know that God's love is free, just like what we're giving them. And it's really more than the gift. It's the fact that we're giving. It's the act of going out and serving. That's what it's all about. Servant evangelism. And the purpose of servant evangelism, you know, it's not to glorify the Praise Center. Believe it or not, it really isn't. I think the Praise Center sometimes gets a little bit of glory, but that's just God's grace. Really, it is. It's about glorifying His kingdom. It's about spreading His kingdom. We encourage people to get into a church somewhere. You know, if they want to check us out, well, by all means, come on. We've got a lot to offer, but we encourage people to just get involved somewhere. We try to turn the tide in their hearts so that they see that there's something to a relationship with Jesus. There's just something special about going out and giving of yourself, your time, your efforts, a little water, a few mints, some cotton candy, some popcorn. We serve, and we have a blast doing it. If you're looking for a way to really feel like you belong, to get involved in doing what Christ did, which was serve, then join our servant evangelism projects. Get involved on the team. We need some men on the team, by the way. It's lonely here in this sea of estrogen. We need a few men. But we have a good time. We've got cool toys like backpack dispensers. We can dispense coffee and water and all kind of good things. We've got just tons of fun. We've got great people that love serving, and that's what we're about. And you know what? It actually attracts people here. It really does. Every single time we've ever gone out, we've had people say, where are y'all from? What are y'all doing? Like, you're actually giving things away? I mean, we were at one festival. We were the only church providing free items. Everybody else was charging. And people thought, how can you afford to do that? And I said, how can we afford not to? You don't pay for God's love. Amen? It's free. Right. So servant evangelism, it's not what we do, it's who we are. Say that with us. It's not what we do, it's who we are.
All right. Awesome.
Well, you have seen this morning, and you have heard other testimonies. This one thing this church does well is eat. And we are under the awesome leadership of our food ministry captain, Chef Jack Perpall.
What do you have? What do you have? What do you have? Yeah, we can do it. Pastor, what an honor it is to be able to celebrate another milestone of 34 years. It was about 16 years ago, I think, that my family came here because God was calling us to a deeper walk. I had no idea how deep you were going to take us, but and the journey that we were going to be on, but it is indeed a blessing. And I just wanted to tell you how much I appreciate all that you do for us and the spiritual feeding that you give us. You give us the word, you feed us, you prepare us, you lead us, and for that we're eternally grateful. You are indeed a true friend and a true shepherd, and we thank you for that. And you always give, and you always give, and we just thought that it would be only appropriate that the food ministry feed you. So we would like to give you and Miss Deborah two of your favorite pies, so you can truly be physically fed as well. So. Wow. We love y'all. Thank y'all so much.
Oh, my goodness. I'll give you a piece of mine if you give me a piece of yours. How about that? All right. blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of love, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Seated in his presence.
I'd like to ask our wonderful board to come up, please.
Pastor, happy 34th anniversary. I'm going to speak for myself, but I'm sure I speak for these other guys as well. It is an honor to be able to serve on the board, an honor to be asked to be served. You are not only our shepherd, but you are our friend. And we treasure the friendship that we have with you. We treasure the time that we have here. This is my home away from home. And I don't mean that just because I spend so much time here. That's not necessarily the case. I mean, it's because this is where I feel most at home. This is my family. I am closer to some of you than I am some of my own family, and you are my spiritual father. And so as the board, we wanted to give you a token of our appreciation. There's just not any way that we could truly show how much we love and appreciate you. So if you and Deborah would come forth, because she's a part of you and a part of your ministry. Again, this is just a token from us to you, and as I said, there's no way we could show how much we love and appreciate y'all. So from us to you.
Thank you very, very much. The keys to a new... Oh. Just kidding. That was terrible. I'm sorry. Oh, wow. Warm words of gratitude with a poem. There are wonderful people who give from their hearts and thoughtful and, what does that say?
Unselfish.
Keep reading.
So willing to share, help out, and be there, no matter how busy their day. There are people we count on whose wisdom and caring help everything work out just right. Wonderful people who shine in our lives with their gentle and beautiful light. God bless you. If only you could hear the prayers that fill each thought of you and the smiles that warm each memory of the generous things you do, you'd know you're treasured more than work can say. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. It is a joy to serve with you. And by the way, those were gift cards, iTunes gift cards and a Walmart gift card. They know where I spend most of my money. Thank you so very, very much. It is such a joy to serve with this kind of board. And I'm the elder for the East Atlanta section in the assemblies, and I hear nightmares, and I hear pastors who continually have nightmares with their boards. And it grieves my heart, and it grieves my heart because it should not be that way. And it doesn't have to be that way. And these guys are living proof that you can love each other and even disagree without being disagreeable and push through and find God's will and find God's purpose and God's plan. And so I want to thank you guys for making my life easy. And by the way, these are not yes men. These are not rubber stamp people. They will tell me when they disagree, and I appreciate that about them. But they always do come around to see it the way God wanted them to. In the end,
wait a lot of next meeting.
I'm just kidding. And
I got a note.
I got an automatic note at our next meeting. So, but anyway, it is a joy. Thank you guys, and thank you for giving me 34 years to serve the most incredible congregation that any pastor could ever hope for. You are indeed my joy and my crown. And I love every one of you. Thank you so very, very much. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Love you.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Go God. Thanks to our youth and fine arts department for that incredible presentation of the gospel. There are all kinds of different ways to preach the gospel, and you just saw a very powerful demonstration of the reality that the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but Jesus comes to give us life in that more abundantly. Amen. Amen. I think that's where it goes. Thank you. Perfect. Strong, able-bodied men. Praise the Lord. As you can well see, we have quite a bit going on here at the Praise Center, and it is such an awesome, awesome privilege for me to be able to lead such a group of dedicated workers, dedicated followers. They say that shepherds produce shepherds, sheep produce sheep. You've seen a lot of shepherds here today who are leading God's people in a lot of different and various ways. And so I would like for you to give a praise to all of those who are following God's call to do that. Hallelujah. You know that it's a God vision when you cannot possibly humanly consider ever doing it on your own. That's how you know it's a God-sized vision. And you can tell already that I am not alone. There are many, many people who have caught the vision and who have caught the passion and caught the call from God to take the Praise Center to where we're going. A few weeks ago, I abandoned the message that God had given me in the middle of a series to do what I felt led of the Holy Spirit to do, and that was to bring our church to repentance as a corporate body, to ask for forgiveness of anything that we had done to hurt anyone ever, knowingly or unknowingly, and also to forgive from our hearts corporately any who had hurt us in any way, shape, form, or fashion, and to release those people from any judgment or criticism or further unforgiveness. We did that. We cleansed our hearts that day. And I believe that was a breakthrough day. I believe that was a monumental breakthrough in the spirit realm that has launched us forward so that you can see things like you have seen here today. And some of you weren't here that Sunday. Some of you were not able to be here for various reasons, and you did not hear my heart in restating the vision that God has for this church. We've gone through a lot of changes over the years. We've gone through a lot of different means and ways, but God is bringing me back to the core of the vision that he gave me 34 years ago when we came here, and that is to be a hospital. Whatever else we may be, God has always had it in my heart to lead a group of people in being a hospital, a place, a safe place where people can come and be healed spiritually, emotionally, physically, relationally, in every way possible. Proverbs 29:8 says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Where there is no vision, the people perish. That's the King James. The NIV says, where there is no revelation, the people cast off restraint. The New Living Testament says, when people don't receive or accept divine guidance, they run wild. They let go. They neglect the things of God. I want to keep the vision fresh for us here. We are a hospital. And in being a hospital, that means that the wounded, the broken, the sick, the disillusioned, the hurting, the down and out, the up and out, those disillusioned with religion, those looking for real people, are the ones who are going to find their way here. And when they find their way here, they're going to find love, and they're going to find acceptance, and they're going to find forgiveness. It's going to be a safe place. It's going to be a safe place where people can run into. We're in our Old Testament study, and we've been talking about cities of refuge. Well, this is a church of refuge. This is a house of refuge. This is a place where people can run to and know that they're going to be loved, they know they're going to be accepted, and they know they're going to find forgiveness. They're going to find the forgiveness of God. They're going to find the acceptance of his people and him, and they're going to be able to be restored, as you've heard testimony about today. We're not only a hospital, but the other part of the vision that God had given me is that we're to be a bridge. The Praise Center is to be a bridge, a place that can help people who are in dead religion find spirit-filled worship, find a place where the gifts are free to operate, a place where the Holy Spirit is free to move and free to direct lives. And I want you to hear my heart. Some people mistakenly think because there's not a certain manifestation of one of the gifts that maybe we're not being led of the Spirit. I want you to understand lives are being changed every time we come together. The word of knowledge flows almost every week. Word of wisdom happens many times. The prophetic anointing comes many times during the middle of the sermons. Just because you may not hear a message in tongues or you may not have an interpretation every Sunday doesn't mean anything other than this church is maturing. Not compromising, but maturing, because it is the lost that seek a sign. It is the carnal that seeketh after a sign. We don't have to have a sign. And the word says tongues are for a sign. Not for them that believe, but to them that believe not. So until you start doing what we're all supposed to do and bring the lost in here, then there's probably not going to be many manifestations of that particular gift, because that gift is not for the body, it's for the lost. Doing my best. And so we're a bridge. We're to be a place where people who have been in dead religion can cross over into the spirit-filled realm, can cross over into spirit-led worship, can cross over where the Holy Spirit controls the service and not a man or a woman or a committee, but where the Holy Spirit is free to move and change things and go in different directions. They're going to come into a place where they sense, when they get out of their car and when they walk in, they're going to sense there's something more here than what I've been used to. They're crossing over out of dead denominationalism sometimes into a vibrant, spirit-filled worship experience where they sense the presence of God is really there. And they can't deny that there's something supernatural going on. So they cross that bridge out of where they were into where God has been calling them all along, deep calling to deep, deep calling to deep. This is a place, this is a bridge, this is a place where that can happen in a safe environment, where people can cross out of darkness into light and can cross from hopelessness to genuine faith, real faith, a real faith that sees you through. Not an escapism faith, but a real faith that says you'll go through the flood, but you won't be drowned. You'll go through the fire, but you won't be burned. A real deal kind of faith. It's a place where they can cross the bridge from being wounded to becoming warriors and worshipers. It's a bridge where the broken become healers. They came here as a patient, and then they become doctors and nurses and specialists and technicians. And every role is just as important as any other role. The ones in the nursery in God's eyes are just as important as the one in the pulpit. Hallelujah. And the one behind the camera or running the sound or the lights or the recording, they're just as important as the ones up here leading worship and praise. And the whole team working together, whether it's through the life groups or servant evangelism or the children or the youth or whatever it may be, everyone's working together to make this a hospital of excellence, to make it a place where nobody would ever be left out, where nobody, regardless of their age or the color of their skin or their economic status, would feel any different than anybody else, because in God's house, we're all God's children and we're worshiping one God. And that's the vision that we have had for 34 years when we came here, when Deborah and I left the comfort zone of being in another ministry and moving from our home and from the land that her daddy had given to her, and we moved here with nothing. Nothing but a passion, nothing but a vision, nothing but a dream that God has supernaturally placed in our hearts. And now today, 34 years later, you see that it went from Deborah and I and a guitar singing, "This is the day that the Lord has made," because I only knew three chords. And every song we sang was in the same key, because I only knew D, G, and C. And for all the guitar players out there, you know that's how it is sometimes. I don't know why anybody in their right mind would write anything in F sharp minor or E flat or any of those goofy chords that guitar players just go, that's not possible. But we came from that. We came from that guitar and those three chords leading a little band of people in worship and praise. Till today you have Infusion, you have children's ministry, youth ministry, women's ministry, men's ministry, nursery ministry, servant evangelism, care ministry, prayer ministry. We have all these things. And it's to God be the glory. Great things He has done. Great things He has done. And I'm very aware of the time, so I just want to reinstate and just reiterate the vision God's put in our heart. If anybody asks you, what is the vision of the Praise Center, you can very simply let them know, we're a hospital. We're a bridge. You can let them know that. We can have our other things about we want to be a relevant community where people can experience God and be encouraged in their spiritual journey and be empowered to serve others. That's all good. That's all true. But bottom line, it all nails down to this. We're a hospital and we're a bridge. And we continually cry out, come on board. Join us. Help us. There's tons and tons and tons of broken people, wounded people, shattered lives that need to cross over from wounded to warrior, from sick to whole, from light and from darkness to light. And if we all do it together, there is no stopping. There's no shortage of what can happen. Look what happened today. Just when a few of you just invited some friends and family. Just when a few of you said, hey, it's homecoming, it's anniversary. How about coming to church? Let's look. We could fill this place up two or three times on Sunday with just a little effort if we really start buying in and saying, it's my place. It's not the pastor's place to get everybody in. It's not the board's place. It's not the staff. It's not the ministry leader. It's my place to bring somebody to this hospital and let them find healing and let them find restoration and reconciliation. So I'm asking you, I'm asking all of us, less finish 2013 strong, super strong. Make a commitment. Make a commitment. I'm going to be in the presence of God unless I absolutely can't get there, unless I absolutely physically or whatever cannot put one foot in front of the other. No matter what, there's two times to be at church, when you feel like it and when you don't. And you will not believe the number of times people tell me, I knew I was supposed to be there, and I let the enemy talk me out of it. And they're regretting it because they missed a powerful move of God's Spirit that day. Don't miss. And don't let the rest of the world miss out on the power of God and on what God has for us. Influence your friends. Influence your family. Influence your neighbor. Influence people and say, look, come with me. Come with me to God's house, and let Him touch your heart. Let Him touch your life. Let Him change you like He did me. Amen? That's all I need you to do. That's all I'm asking you to do. Praise the Lord. One of the ministries that we have not highlighted yet because I wanted to save it to the end was our prayer ministry under the leadership of Belinda Purpall, and so she's going to come and close this service out in prayer and praying over you. And I just want to thank you one last time. Thank you. Thank you for letting me be your leader for 34 years. It has been a trip. It has been a journey. It has been a joy. Amen. God bless you.
You hear me? Okay. I just had to kind of spring off of what Tricia said. And going into the prayer ministry, something happened inside of me when Pastor did the series on the 23rd Psalm. I have never and will never look at that scripture like that ever again. But God used that to begin something in me. I've always had faith in God, but something happened, something changed. So I just got to share with you. God had spoken to me a few months ago about going to the park and praying every morning. And I thought, well, you know, I can't do that, Lord. That's just too much to ask. But let me tell you, it has changed my life. I have seen miracles happen in my life because of that. I had sinus issues and asthma for 10 years and was on an inhaler and medication that I'd been on for 10 years. And God has healed me of that. 3 weeks with none of that medicine. I also got a report from the doctor that I had a third vertebrae fracture, and I got a call the day before yesterday that the fifth one had a fracture. And I said, well, no, it doesn't. Because I was in service about 4 weeks ago, and God said, I couldn't get my hands any higher than that. Raise your hands and praise me. You're going to be healed. And I can move my neck, and I can do whatever. I'm healed. In Jesus' name, I'm healed. And it's because I started praying, and I said, God, I'm getting down to business with you. Here's the things that I need you to do in my life so that I can reach out to other people, and you can get the glory for it. And he has just, I mean, it's just one miracle after another. The greatest miracle was salvation. But just because sometimes we might not see things in here like we think we ought to, they're happening. They're happening in people's personal lives, and we need to share those to encourage each and every one of us that need miracles. But I just thank God that he is continuing. He dropped a job in my daughter's lap. He provided $1,000 for my other son-in-law who needed surgery. And you know what? God has just been, every morning when I go to walk, he says, you got to pray specific. What do you need specific today? And first of all, I just praise him for what he's already done. And then he woke me up that morning and he gave me the strength. But I tell you, prayer, God has shown me, he has renewed that in me. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Spending time with him, that relationship, that's the key. When you get off of that path and you veer off of that path, it just ain't going to work. You got to come back. Got to come back. And then you'll see him start to move and work. We will in our lives. And I just thank him and I praise him and I give him all the glory. The very next day, though, after I testified about that, I had those symptoms. My neck was hurting. I told Pastor, my neck was hurting. I was all stopped up, couldn't breathe. And I was like, oh, no, devil, you're not stealing this from me. In the name of Jesus, you can take those symptoms and you can go. And I haven't had another symptom since.
Thanks for sharing that. Well, what can I say? She just said it. Prayer's key. And the prayer ministry is very active here. By nature of what the prayer ministry is, you don't see it a lot because it's done behind closed doors. Many of you go in your prayer closets and you cry out to God. You praise God. Many of you are in the prayer ministry and don't even realize that you're a part of the prayer ministry because I know that you're faithful to pray whether or not you come on a specific day at a specific time. For those of you who don't know, we have an emergency prayer chain for prayer needs. When you call and have an emergency need, we have people who are on call to pray for you. We have an email prayer chain that you can email your prayer requests in, and we have many people on that team that are faithful to pray for you. And another area, we have intercessory prayer that we meet once a week. There's a faithful couple, people who are always here, and we're always interceding for you and for our pastor and for your individual families and our church family. We also have the pastor's prayer partner ministry, and there's many of you who are involved in that. And these people have committed to pray for Pastor in our church every day. And some of you have been members of that team for many, many years. And I know Pastor appreciates it, and I appreciate it from my standpoint also. And with that said, I would like for Pastor and Miss Deborah to come down here. if the board and all of Pastor's prayer partners who are here today could come down, and we would like to pray over them. By the way, if you are on any of those teams I mentioned, raise your hand. You are on the emergency prayer list, or you're on the email prayer team, you're one of Pastor's prayer partners. There's many of you. And if you notice, a lot of the people who raised their hand are also people who stood up here as servants in other areas too. I'm going to ask Rick to lead this prayer.
Heavenly Father, we join ourselves together this morning in one accord to bless our pastor and Deborah in Jesus' name. Father, we lift our hearts and our voices in thanksgiving and honor to you, the giver of every good and perfect gift. And we ask you to bless Pastor and Deborah with a richer and fuller understanding of the depth and the breadth and the height and the width of your great love for them. Bless them with health and wholeness in their physical bodies, and manifest your healing power in them, Father. We ask that you cause them to prosper even as their soul prospers in Christ, and that from the overflow of abundance, they will continue to bless many. Father, we ask a hedge of protection and a covering of your blessings to be around and over their family. Bless each one with health, strength, favor, and prosperity. Holy Spirit, we ask for your continued anointing on this precious couple. May you so fill and overflow their lives that rivers of living water continue to flow from their lives into the lives of others. Father, as you have blessed Pastor with a vision for the Praise Center for the past 34 years, we ask that the vision become even more of a reality. Increase and sharpen his vision, even as it comes to pass. Now, Lord, we confess that you are able to do immeasurably more than we ask or imagine, according to your power that is at work within us. And so we give you all glory and honor and praise for all that has been, is being, and will be accomplished in Jesus' powerful name.
Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for this day. We thank you for the past 34 years, Lord, but we don't look back. We take this opportunity to thank you. We praise you for it. We give you all the honor and glory for it, Lord, but our focus is on the future, Lord. And Lord, in your word it says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can conceive what you have planned for those who love you. Lord, and that's what we're looking toward, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that this is 34 years on a journey, Lord, that has not ended yet, will not end, Lord, that you have so much more in store for this body of believers. Thank you, Lord. And Lord, right now, we come to you as your children. We've put our faith in you, in the work that Jesus Christ did for us. And because of that, we are your children. And as your children, Lord, we know that we are children of the one true King. We are royalty, Lord, and you have promised so many wonderful things for us. And Lord, right now, I declare that this body of believers will step into position of their royal place, Lord, that we will receive